So I definitely had a lot of my own personal opinion and you know, instincts to draw on. And I'm happy with the storyline, the way they wrote it. I thought it was very ethereal. I felt like it wasn't too dark, it wasn't too dramatic, and it was hopeful. And again, it sort of gave TJ a vulnerability and a strength that I think she might not get right now. I would have liked her to keep a little bit more blood. I was like, fight scene, come on! I have a really comfortable show, but she's on that show too. You can improve it. What's that? Who's back? One of the Lucian girls or something. It's fun. Again. Because I love Julie. Maybe James and TJ would get into a fight. I don't know.
Sorry if I've been late. When you were on the Smallville, I mean, did you find the Black Canary, Dino Labs, did they encourage you to start doing research into it? Because you know, it's sort of a complex relationship that character has with Green Arrow over the years. Did you actually do much of that research?
They didn't require it. I think it's a pretty well-known fact that Tom's never read Superman comic book. They don't require it. They definitely let me know who she was, so I could do some research, and I did it. And I think she's a great character. But ultimately, you know, they really made her their own and didn't really follow the mythology. So, but I'm happy to know it. I think there's a lot of Black Canary fans that I get to talk to, and I like to have a relatability, and I do like that. I think she's way underused and unpopular.
Wait, I think
Just about Smallville. Did you ever think that Smallville would have run for as long as it did, first 10 seasons?
No, I was saying earlier, I don't know if you were here, that when I got the audition in season 7, I was like, that show's still on? It seemed like forever ago, and it was, and everyone really grew up on that show. It's so wonderful to see when something like that happens, because so often in LA, you go in for, you know, an audition, and you think, oh, man, you know, they don't hire me, they're stupid. And then you get a call from your agent, and they're like, oh, they like you, they hired someone else, and then you're like, man, and you just get really upset, and then it lasts half an episode. They pull it during the commercial break or something. And you know, and so when something like this happens, when a loyal fan base and a network really supports a show, and the cast, you know, isn't too dramatic that they have to get rid of them, it's special, and it was a very, very special show, and I'm grateful to be a part of the Superman legacy, and
did you always want to be an actor, or did you want to do something else before you became an actor?
I did a little bit of children's theater when I was 8 or 9, and I sort of always found some sort of creative thing to do performing-wise, and I just would tell my parents, hey, I want to go to this theater house and audition for a children's play, can you drive me there on Sunday or something? Okay, and I'd go, and then when it came old enough, I could take the bus, I would take the bus, and so I always sort of involved myself in something. I never really pursued anything, and then when I was 13, I was approached in a shopping mall, one of those silly stories, and asked if I wanted to be a model. And I was like, hey, crazy person. I'll call you, sure. And so I got their card, and my parents, I said, you know, this person asked me if I wanted to be a model. And so my parents called, and we set up a meeting, and 6 months later, I went to Tokyo, had a contract, and was working as a model. So that kind of took over. And I just thought that was going to be my life. And then I did well. I traveled a lot. I homeschooled myself from high school. And then when I was 18, my parents moved. I'm from Canada, from Vancouver. And my parents moved to the States. They moved to Texas. And since I was under 21, I got a green card. And I thought, oh, great. I'll go and, you know, live in New York or something and be a model. At that time, it was sort of the transition period when a lot of magazine covers, you were starting to see less and less models on the covers and more actresses. And so my agency had said, hey, I see you've done some, you know, commercials and a few acting jobs, theater and whatnot. And I had done a couple of pilots before when I was a kid. And she said, are you interested in acting? I was like, yeah, I remember liking that. And she said, well, we're starting an acting division if you're interested. We had a couple auditions on that. The first audition I did was a movie called Pendulum with Rachel Hunter, and he was also a model turning into an actor, and I was, it was great. I got the job, and I was like, yes, I love this job. You can eat. This is cool. You get to talk and like be a person, not like a mannequin. And so that was it. And ever since then, and that was kind of the time too. Texas is a big independent film hub. And Robert Rodriguez has a studio there, and Sandra Bullock has her studios there, and Steven Spielberg was doing a bunch of stuff there at the time. And this was early 2000, and so I did about 8 movies, a lot of independent films, and I just kept on getting hired because it's a really small community. And I got to the point where I was like, oh, I'm good at this! I can do this! So I moved to LA, and I've been working there since. Work a little, have baby, work a little, have baby. Keep it interesting.
Take anything from the set?
From Stargate? I have my chair back. They sent it to me, which is, you know, Google and SGU. I really want a Kino. They don't really fly. But it'd be cool on a bookshelf. I think it'd be kind of fun to have a date, but I think you need 2 of them. They're really expensive too. So, but no, I didn't really get anything. You know, when they wrap a set, especially if you don't know if you're getting picked up for another season, they can't release anything until the last episode is aired, and then they've got to clear it with all, you know, like a team of lawyers and producers or whatever else. So then they have the big auction, and I don't even want the costumes. So, I have memories. And lots of like fan stuff. I love getting all the like little cards and things like that.
There in Universe there's a lot more female characters in the art stories. All the ladies get together and talk about how strong their characters were, or fuss over what they were going or what they were doing or anything like that.
We had a really nice dynamic of female characters in the show, which is refreshing. The actresses can sometimes be nice to work with. But we had a really, really good group of women to work with, and I felt like the writers, you know, were fair. And gave us all equal storylines. I think that there could have been more. You know, I feel like some of the female characters could have had more to do. I feel like TJ maybe could have been in charge a little bit more, and they did look for opportunities for that. I feel like, you know, Lieutenant James, really that character could have been a little bit more involved. But all in all, we were all fairly happy with what we were given, and no one really complained, and they did absolutely make an effort to everyone in every storyline.